dear students, how are you all? I wish always be well. In today's video, we are going to discuss about electromagnetic waves. Electromagnetic waves or EM waves. So, what are the EM waves? So, electromagnetic waves are generated by the changing electric and magnetic field. Means variable electric and magnetic field. Since the because of change in electric field, magnetic field produces, and because of change in magnetic field, electric field produces. And because of these changes, a type of wave generated in space, and that wave is called electromagnetic waves. So what is the definition? And that propagate in perpendicular to the direction of oscillation of electric and magnetic field. Suppose this electric field is oscillating on suppose this one is z axis, it's a z axis, this one is y axis, and this one is x axis. So if electric field is oscillating on z axis, magnetic field is oscillating on y axis, this is y axis, so then the wave will propagate in the direction perpendicular to these two, that is in x direction. This is very important concept. Wave propagate always in perpendicular to the direction of propagation of electric and magnetic field. And how would you know that the which one will be the, because this one is also perpendicular direction and this one is also perpendicular direction, then how would you know that which one will be the direction of wave? So it's a very important concept. E is, you have taken this one is E na, E field we have considered. So in Z E and in Y is B. Okay, so first of all you will do the cross product. The direction of wave propagation is always, direction is always E cross B. The direction of always, the direction of vector E cross B. So what would be the direction of E cross B? So let's see. So you have studied right hand rule. According to that rule, if we curl the finger in the direction of cross product, then our thumb shows the direction of new vector. Okay, so the direction of wave is perpendicular, the direction of wave is in this direction E cross B. So first of all, we will find the direction of E cross B. The direction of wave is equals to direction of E cross B. So how will you know? So I will put my right this finger in direction of E cross B. It is on y axis. So E cross B, thumb is pointing on x axis. So the direction in this case will be positive x axis. Okay. So if the oscillation is different, then obviously the direction of propagation will be different. But here, if electric field will be on y axis and magnetic field is on z axis, then then cross product of E and B, so direction of E cross B would be E cross B. The direction is negative x axis. But here, since here the direction of x axis E is z axis and this one is y, so E cross B, direction of propagation of wave is this positive x axis. Okay, so by this way we can find out the direction of electromagnetic wave. Sometimes ask in the question in exams that what would be the direction if the electric field is in this direction and magnetic field is in this direction, then what would be the direction of wave propagation. So you can answer that it is in positive x axis or negative x axis, whatever you will find, that will answer. Okay, so what are the electromagnetic waves? Electromagnetic waves are the type of waves which generates due to the changing electric and magnetic field. Which generates due to change in electric and magnetic field and which propagate in perpendicular to the direction of oscillation of electric and magnetic field. Understood? So this is the definition and explanation about the direction of electric and magnetic field. Okay, now we will discuss about what is the source of EM waves. As we have discussed in definition, that source of EM waves are changing electric and magnetic field. But how the changing electric and magnetic field generates? So we know accelerating charge generates varying electric field and magnetic field, or varying magnetic field and varying electric field, magnetic and electric field. Understood? So it generates, accelerating charge generates varying electric field and hence magnetic field, and then again magnetic field will generate electric field. Similarly, the oscillation will work in this way. Okay, like accelerating charge particle will generate accelerating charge particle means what? Accelerating electric field. Accelerating charge particle means what? Since if a charge particle is moving with some acceleration, so obviously electric field is electric force is increasing. So electric force is increasing means what? The electric field is also increasing. So electric field increases with accelerating charge. If electric field will increase, so obviously because of varying electric field, we have studied earlier also that by the varying electric field, magnetic field generates in Hertz Stein-Gerlach experiment, and also in Maxwell experiment, we found that between the parallel plates, the magnetic field generated because of the varying electric field. So we know that because of varying electric field, magnetic field generated, and we know by varying magnetic field also we can generate the electric field. How? By changing the flux. By varying the magnetic field, there will be some induced EMF, and because of induced EMF, some electric field also generated. So by this way, accelerated charge generate electric field, then electric field generate magnetic field, then again magnetic field generate electric field, and so on. Like that, it will the wave will propagate. Means electric and magnetic field will oscillate, and a wave will move or propagate in forward direction. How? We have seen that in case of wave, accelerating charge is not moving, only the wave is moving, energy is moving. How? You have done that one experiment that when you move a rope, the particle of the rope are not moving. Only something is moving from one end to another end. What is that? That is wave, which contains energy. What energy we have provided in the rope, that energy is propagating in the form of wave. Okay, from one end to another end. Understood? So similarly, here the electric and some accelerating charges generate electric field. The electric field generate magnetic field. Like that, it will oscillate, and with this energy, electric energy and magnetic energy, electric energy, magnetic, continuously electric energy converted into magnetic energy, magnetic into electric energy. Like that, it will oscillate and will move to the target. Okay, wherever it is trying to go. Okay, so in this way electric and magnetic field moves, and so the radiation or electromagnetic waves moves, like sunlight rays. And one more important thing that electromagnetic waves can travel in vacuum also. They do not need medium. If they need a medium, then sunlight is also a electromagnetic waves, but it reaches to our earth without any medium. It means electromagnetic waves can move without medium. Even their velocity is maximum in vacuum or in free space. Okay, so electromagnetic waves are the type of waves which do not need medium to travel. Okay, so up to here I hope it is clear. After that is nature of electromagnetic waves. So what is the nature of electromagnetic waves? So we know that electromagnetic waves travel perpendicular to the oscillation of fields. So if any wave propagate in perpendicular to the direction of that source, like in a case of rope, that rope, the particles of rope are oscillating in up and down direction in y axis, then the wave is propagating in x direction. Means always it travel in perpendicular direction. That type of waves we call transverse wave. In the same way, here also electric and magnetic fields are oscillating perpendicular to the direction of oscillation, perpendicular to the direction of propagation of wave, so that it is transverse in nature. So if what is the nature of electromagnetic waves? It is transverse in nature. Okay, why? Because what is the reason behind it? So because electric and magnetic field oscillates in perpendicular direction of propagation of waves. Okay, that's why it is called transverse in nature. Now the last thing, and if the in exam questions it comes that draw the diagram, then you will draw like that. Now electric field, magnetic field on y axis, electric field on z axis. Okay, up, down, electric z axis, and this is y axis. Okay, Now, how can you find the velocity of EM waves? So that I will tell you. What is the formula is given only in your syllabus. So that formula is right here. So formula for velocity of EM waves in a medium is 1 upon root over mu naught mu and epsilon. Okay. Mu and epsilon. In that medium, what is the these constants in that particular medium? That would be, this velocity would be equals to this much. Okay, and also it is equals to E upon B, electric field in that medium to the magnetic field in that medium. Okay, and in free space, the velocity of electromagnetic waves, you know, is velocity of light, because light is also electromagnetic wave, electromagnetic radiation. So the velocity of electromagnetic waves in free space is mu naught epsilon naught, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8, that is equals to E naught B naught, electric field in free space, magnetic field in free space. So these are the two formula for the velocity of waves. You will learn it and you will use these formula for the numericals. Okay. Now the last thing is energy density. For the energy density is also only the formula is given in your syllabus, that is how much. And that energy density U equals to 1 by 2, and electric field energy density is 1 by 2 E naught, E 1 by 2 epsilon naught E square, epsilon naught E square, and energy density for magnetic field equals to 1 by 2 mu naught B square. So these are the formula for the energy density. Okay, so these are the some related terms, and one more thing asked in the question, that why the nature of electromagnetic waves are transverse. So I have explained you what is the source, so that also I have explained. And sometimes asked in the question that in terms of relative velocity, that I will explain in another video, and some characteristics of electromagnetic waves are also left, so that also I will explain in another video. Okay, so up to here you study, and study well. Take care all of you. Bye bye.